Trump campaign is capitalizing on Joe Biden's Breakfast Club gaffe with a $1 million ad buy. The campaign created two ads, with one directly centered on the gaffe itself, another focusing on Biden's role in the 1994 crime bill.
Indeed, that is part of the campaign's overall initiative to win over black voters, which also includes hosting shows like Black Voices for Trump. Mm-hmm. Director of Strategic Communications for the Trump campaign, Marc Lotter, joins us now via Skype to discuss this strategy. Great to see you, sir.
Good to see you, Mark.
Good to see you.
All right, so tell us, what are the plans here?
Well, this is just the beginning, and I think it's important for voters to fully understand and know Joe Biden's background, whether it is just the recent comments that he's made or his involvement in the crime bill, his previous support and alignment with segregationists, the fact that he opposes charter schools, things that mean a lot to the black community. And we'll do it with the black community. We're going to do it with the labor community. We'll do it with anyone that's going to listen, because this is going to be a choice.
So one interesting thing, Mark, that you guys have shared with us before on the show is about how Latino voters in particular have been motivated by the president's message on trade, that the China trade war was actually one of the main things that was resonating there. What do you think is the issues? What can you share with us about not just your effort to win over black voters? What about the president's message is resonating with that community?
Well, I think there are a number of things. First and foremost, criminal justice reform, something that is so important and has caused many people in the black community to take another look at the president. But also, when you contrast that with Joe Biden's record, there is a stark difference. I think also the economic gains that were originally seen by people in the black community prior to the COVID pandemic. And so as we look to rebuild this economy, I think it's important to be able to point out that the president who got the lowest unemployment rate in history, or who saw wages rising, is the one you still want in the White House for another 4 years, going to be very powerful.
Can you just dig into the specifics there a little bit more? So obviously, president signed First Step Act into law. You said you want to point out Joe Biden's record in terms of that 94 crime bill and other sort of law and order legislation that he was involved with. What is the president running on in terms of criminal justice reform, and what is the distinction that you want to draw with Joe Biden on those issues specifically?
Well, I think first and foremost, the crime bill resulted in a large mass incarceration of black Americans. It also caused three strikes and sentencing, those kinds of things, which you saw greatly be reduced and undone under the president's First Step Act. You saw a great majority of the people who were released from prison were black prisoners who are now free. We've seen so many of those stories over the years of people who are now reunited with their families, out becoming productive members of society, having jobs and things like that. So I think it's going to be a very powerful message. It's something that the president's very proud of, and we want to do more.
What are the more steps? I mean, where does he stand on marijuana legalization or descheduling, decriminalizing at this point? What are the additional steps beyond what was called the first step? What's the next step?
Well, I think that's something that they're going to be working on throughout this campaign. We're going to continue to roll that out. I'm going to let the White House and the president actually get into the details of what they're going to propose. It's not something we're prepared to do right now. We'll get there as the campaign unfolds, but that's not something we're going to do today. But the reason why it was called the First Step Act was because it was the first step. And the president has said that we need to do more. We need to continue taking more steps. And I think the president is someone that the black community can trust to do it, because they've seen him do it once already.
And Mark, I wanted to ask you while you're here, as we see states in Georgia, Texas begin to reopen, well, how is the campaign thinking about getting the president back on the campaign trail after we saw Joe Biden emerge for the first time from his basement here? Are we going to see more public appearances, campaign events? What's the internal thinking on that front?
Well, I think right now you're going to see the president in his official capacity as president. We've seen him down in Florida. He's going to be in Florida today. We've seen him in Georgia. We've seen him in Maryland. We've seen him in Pennsylvania and other places recently. So we will continue to see the president go out in his official capacity, talk about getting this country moving again, getting it open again, which is, again, another stark contrast to what we see going on with Democrats, especially with Joe Biden primarily hiding in his basement, and many Democrat governors who are resistant to open up as quickly. So it'll be a very big contrast, but you'll see the president, the vice president out there championing the reopening of this country And today, you will see both of them in Florida championing the return of American astronauts to space from American soil.
That is very cool.
Marc, last question
and
for
I'm,
you.
I'm excited. I can't wait to see it.
That is exciting. Yeah. Marc, obviously, very unlikely that President Trump is going to actually win the black vote, given, you know, the historical trends among the African-American community. What would you see as improvement? What would you see as a win?
Well, I think growing the share that he received is also is another step. We've seen some polls out there that have shown the president doubling his support among black Americans here earlier this year, over the course of last year. And if we can get back to that point, I think it's going to be a very good indicator for us. But I think any kind of improvement is an improvement. And I think what we're seeing more and more, you see it on social media, you see people coming out and saying, I support this president. I like the results I'm getting. And maybe the Democrats have been taking us for granted for too long, as evidenced by the comments by Joe Biden last week. Maybe it's time for people to take another look at this and make their judgments for themselves.
Certainly. Well, Marc, thanks so much for the update. Thanks so much for joining us.
Appreciate it, Marc.
Thank you.
See you later. All right, next on Rising, the Biden's Breakfast Club comments represent a larger issue with the Democratic Party and black voters. Professor Adolph Reed Jr., he's going to weigh in. That's next.